Calvin Kastein at Chazy Central Rural School. It's the 11th day of January 2024, and we're here for a Mountain and Valley athletic conference, varsity boys basketball. Chazy being visited by Boquete Valley Griffins. Boquete Valley roster includes Braden Liberi, number 2, Jackson Hooper, 3, Ben Bertle, 4, Otis Wacken, 5, Bodie Bueller, 10, Ted Gay, 11, Colba Furman, 13, Carson Liebeck, 15, Maddox Rice, 21, and Mason Finney, 6'5". Colby Pulsifer is the head coach. On the Chazy side for Austin Tetro and Travis Dupree's squad, Aiden Howell is 2, Connor Cross, 5, Dylan McAfee, 10, Landon Dupree, 11, Evan Dwyer, 12, Josh Juno, 14, Chase Dickinson, 21, Colby Hernandez, 22, Griffin DeRocher, 23, Cooper Cross, 24, Zamir Foster is number 30, Dawson Hebert is 33, and Parker Baker is number 40. The Griffins are highly favored in this contest. They're just hoping to hang in there and keep it interesting. Jackson Hooper, one of the leading scorers in the area. That's the first points in the game. Here's Dupree. McAfee. Dupree with a shot. Nope. Left out of bounds. Off white. McAfee to Foster. Three under to 5 Cross. Foster gets the rebound. Come the Griffins. Fade away, rolls off the rim. Rebound was pulled down by Dupree. McAfee underneath for Foster. Strong move to the basket by Rice. Eagles get the rebound. Dupree. Excuse me, that was McAfee to Dupree. Now back to Dupree, and stolen by the Griffins. Picked up by Dupree. Give it to Dwyer. Dwyer's got it blocked. McAfee. McAfee. Rebounded by Rice. Hooper. Sticks with it, puts it in. Hooper four, Eagles nothing. 4:27 on the clock. When it happened. We are in a heavy traffic zone here. Oh, count Bert Buehler. Buehler with a trade. McAfee into the fourth quarter. Foster fills it up. And here comes Buehler. Gives it to Berto. And a trade from Liebeck. Makes it 10-0 with 3:35 showing here in the first. Coyer, about every night he's helping out at Northeastern here or here at Chez. Dwyer and McAfee. Eagles looking for their first points of the game. Dupree tries to pass underneath. And the Griffins take it away. Babel. Jamie LaBarge and I agree, it was a travel. Buehler. 15 on the shot clock. Foster won't foul for him. Berto. In a 2-3 defense. Rebound Foster off the top by Berto. 1:53. Eagles still looking for that first point. It ain't happening yet. We're going to have a foul on the Eagles. By Buehler. Working on the perimeter. And to Rice. Pretty hard to stop that big fellow underneath. 12-0. Favor of the visitors. And Griffin's take it away again. Ripper. Somehow the Eagles come up with it. Knocked out of bounds by Liebeck. Sub in. That's Gay, Ted Gay in for Rice. Somehow they kept the shot clock running, even though there was less time on the... And now this time they shut it off. Yeah. 11.9, Shazy scorekeepers said the ball wasn't thrown in until it's touched. The clock doesn't start. That's why they weren't touching it. So, not that it's going to matter here in the long run in this game, but
rules is rules.
So they put 12 on because it's pretty hard to get to 11.9. Stolen. And laid in. Dylan McAfee, and Chasey gets on the scoreboard just before the end of the first period. It's 12-2 visitors. Bueller will inbound to start the second period. Shot clock. Bueller with a shot, and it's off blue. White ball. Boquette Valley. Griffins and Shazy Eagles. Boquette Valley merger of Westport and Elizabethtown Lewis. And they were playing several sports before the merger, and they used that Griffin's nickname because it was the E-Town Lions and the Westport Eagles, so a lion with an eagle head is a Griffin. Works out very much in their favor. They have a mascot all ready to go. Bruno lost it. 24 in for Shazy. Cooper Cross is in for Evan Dwyer. Ripley. McAfee over, back to Dupree, back to McAfee. Versus in. That was Dupree, I think. 12-4. Is he working hard to keep the powerful Griffins off the basket? We're going to call a foul here on 10, I guess, on McAfee. Before the shot, however, is on the drive. Hooper, nope. Rebounded by McAfee. Oh. Hooper. Jackson Hooper. Good second and third effort there, makes it 14-4. Trying to get it to Gay. And we're going to get Rice back in. They'll replace Bueller. 4:51 showing. And Hooper rolls it in for a 16-4 lead. Of the points. Three-pointer, wow. Hooper showing he can burn you inside or out. Makes it 19-4 now. Puts it in. 21-6. McAfee. 21-8. Three to go in the half. Down Dupree. Up to McAfee. Short. And Hooper gets the rebound. Three pointer by Ted Gay. Will be a contender for the Class D title in Section 7. Two on the clock. And we got subs in for both teams. Let's see, Juno's in for, no, excuse me, Dwyer is in for Shazy. And I think three guys came in for Griffin. Cooper Cross, 24-10 now. .127 to go in the half. When the ball was inbounded. Griffins keep it. Eagles take it away. It'll be a carry, no foul. Oh, cross is fouled. 102 showing in a half. It in 5 seconds to go. Dwyer from half court. 26-14. The Griffins lead the Eagles by a dozen here at the half on viewer supported hometown cable. Second quarter was kind of close, 14-12. Griffins outscoring the Eagles. We start the second half. Game. 31-14. Dwyer over to Dupree. Foster throws it up. So back on his feet, getting that rebound. I used to say about kids who couldn't sit still, they had ants in their pants. They must have a lot of ants here at Jay-Z. Rice will shoot. Right back into the forecourt. Cooper. Rice. 35-14. McAfee. And Dwyer, a three-pointer. Evan Dwyer. That, I believe, was number four, Berto. Going for the Griffins. Come up with it. Hooper. Hooper. McAfee. That's the Dupree, and oh, he stepped on the line. But into the second half. He will come up with it. With McAfee. Throws it up. Rebounded by Hooper. Stolen by Dwyer, but can't save it. Oh, Foster gets the rebound. Under four to go in the third. Offensive foul. Yeah. 3:16 on the clock, 40-19 on the scoreboard. Miller in to Berto. Gets it back. Right. Blocked by McAfee. .245 on the clock. Owls in the game. Takes a shot. Lost it. It's a rebound. Puts it in. Third quarter. Ted Gay. Wire with a triple. 44-26. Eagles take it away. Basket by McAfee. 44-28. 108 to go, third quarter. Gay. 50 by Rice. 46-28. Here comes Hooper. 30 seconds, out of time. No basket, what a shot. On the floor before the shot. Nope. Shooting foul is called. Okay. I think he was in the act of looking to shoot, but I don't think he was in the act of actually shooting at the time. But he'll get two at the foul line to make a 20-point lead. 26 seconds to go in the third. Look up. Wake up there. Oop. A little time ran off the clock. That's okay with me. Seven seconds. Also the steal, throws it up and in. Holy cow! The basket is good, of course. Oh, gives the Eagle fans something to cheer about in this 18-point deficit. 3.5 seconds to go. Rebound, Hooper. 38-30 after three here in viewer supported hometown cable. Wire in to McAfee in the fourth quarter is underway. Powell to Foster. Foster throws it up. Foster keeps it alive. Powell picks it up. Ball. Hey. Alberto tying up Aiden Howell. Rebound and Cross misses the shot after getting the ball from McAfee. Rice to Hooper. Nope. Hooper rebounds and he's fouled. don't know if I mentioned it here in the varsity game, and I mentioned it in the modified game. We originally intended to be at Northeastern for El Sable Valley Northeastern girls, but excuse me, at Northern Adirondack, Bobcats and the Patriot girls. But it started snowing around 1 o'clock, and I think I'd rather go the 5 miles to Chazy than the 23 miles with the higher elevation over to Ellenburg. So. Baseline by Liebeck. And earlier today, there was a three-car accident on Route 11 past Ellenburg to the Cherubusco turnoff, 189. The reports we saw online said 5 people brought to the hospital. Following the timeout, action continues. All shot, rebounded by Hooper. Now, a foul on Bueller. Bueller, 15, Liebeck. Four to 30. Griffins leading the Eagles. Strong move by Zamir Foster. Shot by Cross, and it's the off-white. Blue ball. Looks like Hernandez will be coming in for Shazy. Shot is short. Foster with the rebound. Whoa, offensive foul. We got Chase Dickerson coming in too for Shazy. Along with Hernandez. The Griffins, we see number 2 coming in. That's Brady Liberi. 4:42 to go in the game. Three-pointer for Bueller. Who's that? Juno, Josh Juno is out there. Didn't notice him coming in. Over and back. At midcourt. 4:13 on the clock. Making sure they're awake over there. Four minutes. We're 87.5% through the game there. Powell trying to bounce pass. Hernandez to Foster. Good effort there. Nice try, but he's on the line. Dickerson fighting hard for that one. And now we got, hey, wait for it. It's number 11 back in, Dupree. Replace Juno. Somebody came in for Rice on the Griffin side. See a big tall fellow out there. We'll see who that is. Griffins keep it down to 3:16. Down again. 2:44 to go. Well, at this time they took a shot. Okay, the player who came in is number 13, Hoba Furman for the Griffins. Foul shot, rebound Foster. Jump ball. To go, 57-32, 25-point lead for the visitors from Boquette Valley. Hernandez, all the way shot. Rebounded by Liberi. 10 seconds. 59-32 is the score. 5 seconds. Is he going to shoot? Nope. They're not going to shoot. They're not going to shoot. 59-32. Boquette Valley defeats Shazy, and that's the way it was in MBAC Varsity Boys Basketball, January 11th, 2024. You're watching viewer-supported local television, hometown cable, win, lose, or draw, TV worthy of your support. Thank you for watching.